Well, hello and welcome to Click Spotlight. Now, very special Click Spotlight. We're actually in the new King of Prussia office in Philadelphia. And we've got the person in front of the spotlight. We've got Mr. Steve Owens, who has been a huge part of that move from Radnor to the King of Prussia. So what's it been like? No, actually, no, before we get onto that, just explain to anyone who doesn't know you exactly who you are, what you do, and what your role is at Click.
Yeah, so Steve Owens, I joined the company about 2 years ago to lead the procurement real estate function for Click. Click's always had a real estate function, but didn't have a centralized procurement function. So spun that up, hired a small team for procurement, and worked closely with the folks for real estate and facilities to execute that function as well. So
is it the is it the maintenance side of it? Is it all purely?
Yeah, it's the leases, it's the maintenance. Okay. In some cases, it's office management. Although we're fairly distributed with that function around the world and in different functions.
So who's your team then? Who are part of your team?
So key members of my team: Gus Normoyle, who handles a lot of our real estate projects and activity around the world. Jalen Christian, facilities manager regionally here in the U.S. Other key members, David McKinney, Tandy Norville.
Oh, I know Tandy.
For procurement category managers. So, throughout the organization, about 12 or 15 folks, as I recall.
That's a very large remit then, isn't it? Yeah, so lots going on there. And that is something, some of the people here or listening or watching to this now may not be aware. So it's good to get that understanding.
Yep.
So why did we choose King of Prussia? What made this be a good choice for Click?
Yeah, so it really wasn't even necessarily about King of Prussia. It was more about the building. So we set out to look at alternatives within reasonably close distance to Radnor, probably 5 to 8 miles, maybe 10 on the outside. We wanted to stay in the same general area. Looked at a lot of buildings, but when we came here and we walked in and we saw the potential of a building with the high ceilings, the industrial look, to effectively have more or less our own building. We're basically a duplex here. So that really was just very attractive to figure out how do we create an environment that looks and feels like a technology company, something unique, something that can help, bring and add energy to the company. So,
and I like the fact that it's all on the one floor and the central social area as well.
Yep.
Really makes it, because before in Radnor we were split up into the three floors, which kind of helped build silos in a way, didn't it?
Yeah, our biggest pain point to solve was how do we break down those silos? How do we get to a situation where people are having those informal conversations? Even today, I've heard several people say, hey, great to see you. I wouldn't have seen you for 3 months if we were back in Radnor. One was on the first floor, the other was on the third floor on the other side of the core. So it was, I think we were already starting to see people running into each other, spending time together. Yeah. Who probably wouldn't have.
Because there's no real reason to go to the office. Unless you had a proper reason, a work reason, there was no reason to socially just wander around and meet people before, was it?
Yeah. So it really was more about the building and the environment than it was King of Prussia per se.
So how difficult was it to find a building like this in this area? Is there loads to choose from?
No, it's pretty rare, right? So you typically will see fairly standard multi-story office buildings. We looked at 30 buildings, I'd say. When we were doing our search, this was one of two or three that were unique, and this one by far had the most sort of industrial loft type look that myself and others have seen work well with technology companies in creating that environment. So it really was a pretty unique situation.
So how long has it then taken from when you walk through the door of this building to say, yes, this is what we want to go to get to where we are now? What was that? What's the length of time?
Yeah, so that was about 15 months. So the whole process itself was about a year and a half from the time we started looking at reviewing our Radnor lease and what our exit provisions were, starting this property search. But from the time, it's been 1 year since we signed the lease, actually, as of yesterday.
Okay.
So we signed the lease early November 1 year ago. So it's taken about a year to do the design work for the building, to get the building ready. The ownership had some element of the work that they had to do on the outside as well. So that's been about a year-long process.
Okay. And how has the process been? Has it been fairly smooth, or has it been
rocky? It's been there's been some bumps on the road, right? Mm. So it's been challenging, but also rewarding along the way. So every week there's a different challenge, a different issue that pops up that we have to figure out resolution or solve for, whether it be the design. One of the challenges with these older industrial buildings is you have a lot more variation in what you're going to get when you attempt to uncover walls or try to paint directly on roof deck instead of drop ceilings. It just adds a whole nother level of variability as to what you're going to come across.
So if you were to take a learning from this process then and to say, well, this is something I would not do again if I was to go through this again, what would that be?
The biggest thing is I wouldn't try to use what I thought was all of my available time. So as we look at a project and we know lead times, we know industry standards, and we get guidance from the experts and the subcontractors on the project, they'll tell us, hey, you need to make a decision no later than this time.
Yeah.
And it's always tempting to want to use all of that time, get the best possible design, get the most input. Well, what happens when the industry elongates because of hurricanes or of a particular supply chain issue or because of China tariffs creating delays and that tension happening, which we've seen all three of those things happen along the way.
You don't think of that.
So the whole supply chain, we got pinched a couple times where some things were later and they had ripple effects in the project. So I think my learning is I'd be a little, push the organization to be a little more decisive a little earlier so that we had greater safety stock in the schedule.
So you wanted that safety margin, what you're saying.
Yep.
So but rather than being right up to the line. That's incredible, actually, when you think of that. I never would have thought, like tariffs in China, like the hurricanes and storms happening, but it's all going to have an effect, obviously, isn't it?
Yep.
So this building will be evolving. We are where we are now, and it's looking very good indeed. But what are your milestones now going into 2019 and onwards? What are you looking at?
Yeah, so if I think about the building specifically here, part of what we want to do is find even more ways to support our corporate responsibility goals. We have installed here EV chargers and solar panels. We may look to help promote and ensure that we're actually utilizing those EV chargers as much as possible, maybe even allowing other tenants to use them, even though under the lease we have exclusive rights to them.
Yeah.
Better for somebody to use them if we're not ready to use them all.
Yeah.
And part of that, it's a 10-year lease, so over time, we're confident that more and more people will drive electric vehicles over the course of years.
A Click electric vehicle, that would be a Click branded electric vehicle.
Yeah, there that would be cool, right? Mm. So kind of local marketing, kind of guerrilla marketing efforts and park it out there and charge it would be pretty neat.
Yeah, well, you've got Click bikes in Lund, so why not a Click electrical vehicle?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
In King of Prussia.
Yeah, and I think otherwise for me, it's, we've gone through a process of really right-sizing our real estate portfolio and trying to make investments. So here we think we've created a better environment. It's saving a little bit of money as well on the ongoing rent, but that wasn't the primary motivating factor. But we've had a fair amount of excess capacity that we've right-sized this year, so we're mostly done with that activity. So for me personally, there'll be more of a procurement focus likely next year as I spend more time on that side of the house, trying to ensure that we get the best value for the money we're spending with our vendors. So
okay.
A little bit of de-emphasizing real estate, I think, for me going forward, and a little bit more on the procurement side.
Excellent. So your baby is born. The Click building now is in operation. Mm-hmm. But obviously this would have been, the lead up to this would have been incredibly intensive and maybe stressful even.
Yeah.
So when you get home then, and when you sit down after today, how are you going to relax? How are you going to kind of push on back and let that all just slough away?
Yeah, I've got three elementary age children.
Right? Well, that's enough work for you, isn't it?
It's work, but it's probably the most relaxing fun I have. So I enjoy spending time with them, with other kids, with coaching or teaching Sunday school or just enjoying the time with the kids. They're at a great age now where they're not quite teenagers, so they still think it's fun to hang out with mom and dad.
Oh, well, that's good. So they'll go to the mall then with you.
Yeah, they'll do all kinds of things, right? Mm. So that's my kind of number one relaxation. But sports of all kind, real and fantasy sports, I enjoy as well.
Nice.
So, those kinds of things are.
So, what is your favorite sport then? What do you?
Baseball would be baseball. For playing and coaching is baseball. Certainly enjoy watching American football on TV. But
it should never be called American football because they don't kick the ball.
They kick it every now and then.
Every now and again. I sit there and I watch it. It's typical Brit. You know, football, we do football. They don't kick the ball.
That's right.
There you go. It should be handball. That's what they should call it. Okay, so can you cook? You know, in your relaxing time,
I can cook. I can cook. I'm mainly on the grill more than anything. So my wife does the yeoman's work on cooking usually. So I kind of cook out of necessity more than choosing to do it most of the time. But I definitely man the grill and make a nice steak or some swordfish on the grill and try to get creative with those kinds of
things.
That's
a summer thing, though, isn't it? So difficult to do in the winter.
It doesn't have to be. You know, grill into November sometimes. And really? You get the grill out in March. Yeah.
Excellent. Well, maybe because it rains too much at home that we don't do that very often.
Yeah.
So give me a favorite book or film that you have watched more than once and why.
Yeah, you know, I love the big epic fantasy movies, to be honest with you. Yeah, Lord of the Rings trilogy, I've probably seen at least 10
times. I'm with you
times.
On that one. Mm.
Those types of Saving Private Ryan's another kind of epic movie that I've probably seen 10 times. So those kind of movies tend to draw me. I've never read a book twice, to be honest.
Well, Lord of the Rings is the only book I have read twice.
Is that right?
All of them, yes. All of them. That was a long go. Mm-hmm. I tend to with that kind of book, you find bits in there that when you read it the first time, you completely forgot about. So it's a good one to read again. So read it again if you haven't read it already.
Yeah,
well,
good idea.
Steve, it's been an absolute pleasure.
Thank you so much.
And well done on King of Prussia.
Thank you.
It's a really good working space and lots of people, and I can really see them, as we were saying before, getting together more and making it a more cohesive environment for people to have.
Absolutely. It's been a great teamwork across IT infrastructure, facilities, internal communications, getting messaging out to people.
Yeah,
all kinds of external vendors. So for me, it's been challenging, but it's been a great example of teamwork internally and externally that, you know, it's great to create something physical that lives on.
So
much of our professional work is not in physical form. So this is kind of one of those rarities where you can walk around and look at it and say, you know, I remember when we had that problem with that ceiling and what we did and why. And so it's pretty neat to have it physically
there. Well, thanks once again for getting involved in Spotlight, and good to meet you.
Thank you.
Take care.
Appreciate it.